shouldn't have buried me. I'm not dead.
Welcome back, Dead Grinners, to Dead Grin Customs, where we bring lame action figures back from the dead. Today is another custom showcase, and this time we're reviewing my custom Dragon Stars 100% Full Power Frieza 2.0. The first time around, I made a similar video, and I ended up using a Dragon Ball Evolved Broly using the World Collectible Figure head and Dragon Star's feet. But this time around, I kind of improved on the design overall, especially now that we have more Dragon Ball Evolved figures to be able to use. Let me just break it down, like what parts I used. So beginning with the head, we have an SH Figuarts Frieza. The torso and the arms are Dragon Ball Evolved Jiren. The crotch is a Dragon Ball Evolved Jiren. And the legs are from a Dragon Ball Evolved Broly. The feet are from an SH Figuarts Frieza. And finally, the hands and the extra hands that I have are actually from a Dragon Star Jiren. So that's basically the recipe that I used to be able to make this guy. Biggest improvements that I did was I used more parts from the SH Figuarts. I used the tail, this little, I don't know what you call that, chest piece, the head, the feet. All of that came from the SH Figuarts Frieza, a bootleg version of it. And the way I kind of like determined the sculpt, I actually ended up using this picture as more of a reference. It's from the manga. That's where I tried to get the dimensions a little bit better. I also took inspiration from the SH Figuarts cooler that they released. I love the way the overall design for it was, especially around the crotch and the legs. I was wondering how they were going to make it different from the Frieza, and as at the same time be able to accentuate, you know, all that, like the musculature that and the size that SH Figuarts cooler has. So using a little bit of that for inspiration, that's how I ended up sculpting the there's a lot of sculpting actually in here. I sculpted the shoulders, I sculpted the veins that are on the figure. I sculpted this little crotch area, and of course I also sculpted the legs and the gauntlets, if you could see them, and a little bit on the face. Like I try to accentuate the brows a little bit more. The figure is not 100% perfect, but it is a huge improvement in my personal opinion on the last custom that I made. If I could do this again, I would do the same thing, but instead of just repainting everything, because some of the parts do suffer from paint rub, I would have loved to have worked with somebody to cast the parts in all white. That way, the whole figure could have no paint rub, and at the same time, I would be able to, you know, like, I guess duplicate the mold, the sculpt that I do. That's something that I want to work on, you know, in the future. But that's the only improvement that I would do. Here he is in the size comparison with an SH Figuarts Goku. I know that the Frieza does look a little big next to this Goku, but you know, when you do see clips from the manga and in the anime when they're fighting, they're not too far apart in size compared to how when they start, you know, like Goku in his base form and Frieza in his final form. Once he reaches 100% full power, it's like he grows a little bit and Goku's able to, you know, almost, I mean, he's still bigger than him, but he's, you can tell there's a big size difference now from the beginning of the match. I personally like the size. I can see some people wanting to do a smaller one. I've seen people do SH Figuarts Frieza and just sculpt all over the body, but the proportions look very off to me. I like the way the proportions are here. I had to modify a lot, like on this Jiren torso here, the shoulders, I kind of like, you know, try to make him go down a little bit, and then also this waist piece, I try to make it as thin as I could to get more of that V shape, you know, that I feel that the actual art representation has. He does come, like I said, with these extra pair of hands that are Jiren's, and if you just wanted to display him with the upper body cut in half, I do have an extra hand or an extra arm that could be that could replace his arm and basically become, you know, the mutilated version that he is like towards the end of the fight. So there you go. That's how he looks with, you know, without the legs and the extra appendage. Like it's the missing of an appendage. I just love the way this came out. I love how smooth and clean it came out. One thing I do kind of regret is the purple. I wish I would have gone more of a metallic-y purple, you know, dark, deep one, just to match the latest SH figure arts, and then add a little bit of a blue shadow like to the muscles. That way he could look a lot more like the SH figure arts, but I'm happy with it. But what do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section down below. Do you guys think this is an improvement, or did you like the one before? Let me know. And as always, guys, you know, be prepared. There's more coming, more shorts, more custom showcases, and more action figure reviews. Peace.
Alright, listen up, monkeys. Subscribe to Dead Grin's Customs before I infect you all and make you my slaves.
Okay, guys. If you guys liked today's episode, make sure you let me know in the comment section down below. Please make sure to like, subscribe, and share the video. And make sure you follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram to stay up to date with all my customs and everything outside this channel. Like I always say, if you're watching this in the morning, good morning. And for everybody else, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.